ਗ੍ਰੀਵਲ ਸ਼ੋ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਮੇਰੇ ਵੱਲੋਂ ਗੁਰਿੰਦਰ ਗਰੇਵਾਲ ਵੱਲੋਂ ਸਾਰਿਆਂ ਦਾ ਬਹੁਤ ਬਹੁਤ ਨਿੱਘਾ ਸਵਾਗਤ ਸਤਿ ਸ਼੍ਰੀ ਅਕਾਲ ਸਾਰਿਆਂ ਨੂੰ ਵੈਲਕਮ ਟੂ ਦ ਗ੍ਰੀਵਲ ਸ਼ੋ ਅੱਜ ਦੇ ਸ਼ੋ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਮੇਰੇ ਜਿਹੜੇ ਗੈਸਟ ਨੇ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਤੁਸੀਂ ਮਿਲ ਕੇ ਬਹੁਤ ਹੀ ਖੁਸ਼ੀ ਮਾਣ ਕਰੋਗੇ ਕਿਉਂਕਿ ਉਹ ਸਭ ਤੋਂ ਪਹਿਲੇ ਪਾਕਿਸਤਾਨ ਬੋਰਨ ਕੈਨੇਡੀਅਨ ਇੰਡੀਵਿਜੂਅਲ ਜਿਹੜੇ ਕਿ ਓਨਟੇਰੀਓ ਦੀ ਪੀ ਸੀ ਪਾਰਟੀ ਦੇ ਮੈਂਬਰ ਨੇ ਆਪਣੇ ਲੋਕਲ ਏਰੀਏ ਦੇ ਐਮ ਪੀ ਪੀ ਨੇ ਮਿਸਿਸ ਅਗਰ ਕੁਕਸੁਲ ਈਸਟ ਤੋਂ Khalid Rashid Oni, mere naal aaj studio vich ne. Welcome, sir.
Thank you very much for having me.
Asi thoda welcome karna chahunde hain Grewal's show de upar. Te aaj asi janna chahunde hain thode bare. Who is Mr. Khalid Rashid?
Well, first of all, thank you so much, Mr. Grewal, for having me on your show. I was actually born in Pakistan.
I'm
from Karachi.
Okay.
And I came here in early 2000.
Okay.
And did my high school and then my university over here, and started my career with a financial institution, and then continued, and then decided to enter politics.
So basically all your life you have been in Canada?
Almost, yeah, like close to 20 years or so, yes, absolutely. Me and my family have been in Canada.
Okay. And how did you end up being a politician?
So I was always very much into politics from a grassroots level, and I was playing active roles in different ridings, associations, and you know, different party events.
Okay.
And then back in 2018, during the provincial election thing, I decided to put my name forward. We had our nomination in 2017, and I was fortunate enough to win, to get elected for the nomination, and then in 2018 became the MPP from Mississauga East, Cooksville.
Now, always the general public likes to know as to why an individual picks a certain party to go with. To see PC party, kyun choose ki?
So the reason I decided to run with the PC is because of the shared values that I believe, whether it's a fiscal responsibility or a social. I'm a very fiscal conservative individual.
Mm-hmm.
I believe that we have to run our own house in a very fiscal manner, so to make sure that, you know, I'm a father of four kids.
Oh, okay.
Yes.
You're a busy man.
No, but I'm very fortunate to have a supporting wife, and especially my parents as well too. They live with me, so you know, we have a full house, but everybody supports each other, so that's why
I'm able to do
what I'm doing in politics. And at the end of the day, I came into politics because I believed in this government, in the PC party, that we are going to fix the mess that was left by the previous government, and to make sure that our future generation have a better province.
Mm-hmm.
than we have today. And I'm really happy and proud that our premier, Honorable Doug Ford, and the entire team is working day and night to make sure that we do something positive for our next generation.
Now, coming back to Mr. Ford.
Yes.
and the PC party itself, you've been in an office over 1 year.
Yes, it's going to be actually 2 years in June.
Yes, so time keeps on running. So in the year and a half, basically, that you've been in office, what's the main work which your riding has accomplished?
So my riding, so basically what we have been doing is that, it's not just about the riding, it's about the province as well too.
Okay.
But if you talk about my riding, we actually, if you look at the Mississauga as an entire, we basically released the funding for the LRT project. We are working on rental housing projects as well too. We have invested a lot in infrastructure. As a whole, we are trying to fix a lot of mess that was left by the previous government. Now, see, when we came into power, we inherited a huge debt. I mean, this province
from the previous liberal
government under Kathleen Wynne. And people have to remember that on average, our interest payment is roughly about $13.5 billion a year. That's just our interest payment.
So that's the Ontario taxpayers are paying for that?
Yes, Ontario taxpayers are paying $13.5 billion a year just on interest payment. So when you look at the balance sheet, as an example, the number one expense from our province perspective is healthcare, then it's education, then it's Ministry of Children and Community and Social Services, and then the fourth line item is the interest payment.
Oh.
So I call it like a ministry of debt or a ministry of interest payment, because that's the fourth largest line item on our balance sheet. So when you look at that number and you look at what are we leaving our children for their future, we need to make sure that we have to fix this mess. And because right now our overall debt of this province is $350 billion.
That's which we're paying interest payments.
Payment on. And you just imagine like $350 billion. That's like some countries don't even have that much of debt that we as a province have right now. So we have to, again, going back to my earlier point, we have to look at our future generation. We have to make sure that we leave a province which is prosperous and our children can enjoy and can also, you know, be part of this province and be proud of what we are doing.
Now, I was reading about the PC party in Ontario.
Yes.
That they have done a lot of things for seniors.
Yes.
Can you elaborate on any of those?
So we actually just recently introduced the free dental care program. So
okay.
If as a senior, you if you're age 65 or over, you qualify for a senior care program, which is like, it's completely free. And whether you are single or a couple, you qualified for this dental care program.
So I think I would suggest ye kar tusi ehi gal urdu de vich ko taan jo apne jehde sare viewers ne unna nu vi samajh lagge ki unna de bujurg jehde gharan de vich rehnde ne unna nu kinna fayda ho reha government da.
So basically agar aap ki umar jo hai wo 65 saal se over hai to aap jo hai wo free dental care program jo hamare sube ne announce kara hai aap uske liye qualify kar sakte hain. Aapko sirf jo hai wo Ontario ki website pe jana hoga. Free dental care ki website hai.
Okay.
Us pe jaake simply aap apply kare. Actually mere khud ke parents ne abhi recently apply kara, and it's a very easy process.
Oh, okay.
Aap online jaiye, wo online ek form hota hai, wo aap bhare, aap submit kar de, aur phir aapko ek dental card aayega. और उस कार्ड के थ्रू उस पे वहाँ पे डिफरेंट ऑप्शंस होते हैं कि आपने जैसे पील रीजन के अंदर कहाँ कहाँ पे आप डेंटल केयर के लिए जा सकते हैं,
ठीक
तो
है.
आप जाइए और आपका डेंटल केयर जो होगा वो फ्री होगा.
लो जी, आज देख लो कितना फायदा हो गया अपने घर के विच जेडे बुजुर्ग बैठे ने, मम्मी डैडी किसी दे भी है ना, किसी ने भी कोई डेंटल वर्क करवाना जी ओवर 65 ने तो इहदा फायदा ले सकते ने. उन्होंने वापस अपने इंडिया पाकिस्तान जाने की लोड़ नहीं, क्योंकि बहुत फैमिलीज इंडिया पाकिस्तान जाके dental work करवा के लेके आंदियां ने.
Yeah.
So it's good to get it done right here in Ontario.
Yeah, absolutely. अगर आपकी जो as a single individual अगर आपकी income जो है वो 19,000 approximately 19,000 से कम है तो you qualify for yearly income जो है, so you qualify for the free dental care program. और अगर आपकी जो as a couple है उसकी एक सालाना जो income है वो 33,000 से कम है तो you qualify for the free dental care program.
So there are basic guidelines to qualify.
Absolutely. और
okay.
और हमारी गवर्नमेंट देखें, अगर आप जैसे आपको भी पता है कि राइट नाउ वी आर एक्सपीरियंसिंग ए क्राइसिस इन द हेल्थ केयर एट द मोमेंट. लाइक यू नो, इफ़ यू गो टू एनी हॉस्पिटल और आप कभी भी किसी हॉस्पिटल में जाते हैं तो आप देखते हैं कि एक लंबी लाइन लगी हुई होती है.
दैट्स ट्रू.
ठीक है. और उसके एक सबसे बड़ा जो एक मसला है, अगर आप जाएँ तो अक्सर होता है कि वो जो ओरल जो आपकी हेल्थ है ना, जो आपकी जैसे कहते हैं ना कि उर्दू में मसूड़ों की जो एक है, उसकी वजह से लोग अक्सर जो है वो हॉस्पिटल जाते हैं क्योंकि वो काफ़ी जो है बीमारियां उसकी वजह से काफ़ी होती हैं.
oh, okay.
तो हमारी गवर्नमेंट ने ये फैसला किया कि बजाय इसके कि हम, क्योंकि हमारा एट द एंड ऑफ द डे वी वांट टू रिड्यूस द वेट टाइम in the hospital. Like, you know, we are trying to,
which has been going on for a number of years.
Exactly. So we thought, okay, what is one reason why we see a lot of seniors going to hospital? And then we realized that, you know, the oral issue is one of the issues why our seniors go to the hospital. So why not make sure that our seniors can go and for their routine checkup, oral routine checkup. This way they don't have to end up in an emergency in a hospital or something.
So
that's how we are trying to tackle certain things.
So this way at least there will be less people going to the hospital. Then come end of the day, the wait times will be lowered and everything will be...
Absolutely.
There will be a happy ending.
Yeah, absolutely. That's the whole idea. And, you know, we are increasing long-term care beds as well too. Our commitment is about 15,000 long-term care beds in this province, because, you see, I can invest as a government, we can invest billions of dollars in hospital services, but that's not going to remove the core issue that we see in a hospital, which is the hallway healthcare.
The problem
is that the beds are being occupied right now because these individuals are respected individuals who are occupying a bed cannot go to a long-term care facility because there is no long-term care bed available, and that's causing the effects of finding a bed in a hospital. It takes hours and hours and hours. So
we'll go to a short break.
Sure.
So to see dekh rahe ho Grey World Show asi hune ke te hune aaye. Thank you. Welcome back, Grewal Show ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਮੈਂ ਤੁਹਾਡਾ ਹੋਸਟ ਗੁਰਿੰਦਰ ਗਰੇਵਾਲ ਅੱਜ ਜਿੱਦਾਂ ਤੁਹਾਨੂੰ ਪਹਿਲਾਂ ਦੱਸਿਆ ਕਿ ਸਾਡੇ ਕੋਲੇ ਪਹਿਲੇ ਪਾਕਿਸਤਾਨ ਬੋਰਨ ਕੈਨੇਡੀਅਨ ਇੰਡੀਵਿਜੂਅਲ ਜਿਹੜੇ ਕਿ ਪੀਸੀ ਪਾਰਟੀ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਐਮਪੀਪੀ ਨੇ ਮਿਸਿਸਾਗਾ ਕੁਕਸਵਿਲ ਈਸਟ ਤੋਂ ਕਲੀਦ ਰਸ਼ੀਦ ਹੋਣੀ ਸਾਡੇ ਕੋਲੇ ਸਟੂਡੀਓ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਪਹੁੰਚੇ ਹੋਏ ਨੇ ਤੇ ਉਹ ਇਨਫੋਰਮੇਸ਼ਨ ਦੇ ਰਹੇ ਨੇ ਆਪਦੀ ਗਵਰਨਮੈਂਟ ਬਾਰੇ ਕਿ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਦੀ ਗਵਰਨਮੈਂਟ ਕੀ ਕਰ ਰਹੀ ਹੈ ਓਨਟੇਰੀਓ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਤੇ ਸਾਰੇ ਆਪਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਸਿਟੀਜ਼ਨਸ ਨੂੰ ਕਾਹਦਾ ਫਾਇਦਾ ਹੋ ਰਿਹਾ ਸੋ ਵੀ ਵਰ ਟਾਕਿੰਗ ਅਬਾਊਟ ਸਮ health crisis issues which your government is trying to handle.
Yes, so before we went on the break, I was just mentioning that the reason why these beds are being occupied continue to be occupied is because we don't have long-term care beds available so what we as a government are doing right now is that we are investing in long-term care beds so that these individuals who are in a hospital bed can actually come out of hospital, go in the long-term care facility, so that the people who are waiting in an emergency room or in a hallway can actually go and occupy a bed in the hospital. That's how we are trying to reduce the wait time.
So now this is really good, but something has been triggering me all along. You also said that you are a father of four children. Yeah. And I'm sure they go to school.
Yes.
Nowadays, or it's been several weeks now, in Ontario, the teachers' unions, and when I say unions, I mean all the unions, have been going on strike.
Yes.
We want to hear from you as the MPP of the governing Ontario PC party as to what is the issue.
So the real issue is the compensation.
Okay.
If you see as a government, when we introduced the bill where we said that every public sector employee will get an increase of 1% for the next 3 years, that was agreed and accepted by all public sectors, individuals, unions, except the teachers' union. So based on the 1%, we are saying that we will increase your salaries by 1%, which is in equal comes to about $750 million
for all the teachers in Ontario.
The teachers union is saying no, we want $1.5 billion, which is 2%.
So
now if you see, I would rather invest that the additional $750 million in the system to make sure that our children have the best education possible. And not that they don't have it right now, but we want to make sure that our children are successful. We want to keep investing money in the education system and not in the compensation.
So when we are looking towards the teachers' unions or the minister's office having meetings or negotiations, and then the negotiations break off.
Yes.
Then the teachers go on strike.
Yes.
What happens to the kids?
Exactly that. See, that's what we have been saying, that why do kids have to suffer? Kids should be in the classroom. They should not be staying outside the classroom. And that's why we are making sure that we are every day reminding the unions to come back to the table. We have a private mediator. Let's have a negotiation and let's find a way. The only issue right now is the compensation. At the end of the day, it's a taxpayer's dollar. Right now, in the beginning of your show, we talked about the interest payment and the debt that this province currently has. Now, you as a taxpayer, would prefer your money or your taxes to go into the system to make the system better.
That's correct.
Right? That's exactly what our government is saying as well, too, that we should be investing the funds or taxpayers' dollars into the education system. The unions are saying, give us 2% or we will continue to do the strike. Now, how is it fair to the taxpayer?
Well, I agree, but there was also a report just recently that there was $7.1 million given out to the parents of students who were staying home.
No, so what we as a government are saying that, you know what, we will, again, if there is a strike, which means that one of the parents has to stay home, because from grade 1 to 8, or 1 to 7, I mean, you know, you want your, there must be a supervision.
That's correct.
For kids.
An adult.
Yeah, an adult or something. So what our government is saying that, look, we would pay up to $60 a day per child, depending on the age bracket or the bracket of their classes, we will pay the parents those funds, because we want to make sure that the parents continue to have the peace of mind that they can go to work while we continue to work with the unions. So far, around 300,000 parents have already signed up, which means that
to get the money when they're staying home with their children.
No. So basically that money, what we are saying is that, you know, if you have to have a child care or something like that, you don't have to worry about it. The funds are not coming out of your pocket. Rather, the government is going to support you. And that's exactly what we are doing. But the unions keep continuously would like to have this. Unfortunately, these strikes are once a week or twice a week, just because they would like to have 2% increase in their salaries.
So what I'm hearing from you, sir, is that it's not basically the teachers who are doing it; it's the union shops.
Yes, I mean I've spoken with so many teachers myself, and they actually they have said to me that, you know, they don't want these strikes. They don't want these strikes. They want to continue to teach our children. We have the best educators in the world right here in Ontario, and the teachers would like to continue to teach. And as a government, we would like our students to continue to be in their classrooms where they are learning, because they are our future, and we want to invest in our children. But the unions keep saying, no, we need 2%, which means an additional $750 million, which equals to $1.5 billion.
So Mr. Rashid, is your government going to bring in any action whereby no strike will happen within the teachers' union?
You mean in terms of
legislation?
Legislation.
That's
so
right
now, in all good faith, we are continuously working with unions because we want to go through the process of negotiations, mediations, and stuff like that. So right now, because, you know, today there is a strike going on in Peel region.
That's right.
Because the conversations are going on right now, so I cannot say much about the future plans. But what I can tell you right now is that we are very much sitting and requesting the unions to have a conversation. Let's just focus on our children. And let's just focus on investing money in our children. Not that, you know, we need 2% or we will continue to do strike. And one thing I want to mention over here, if you go back, let's say, like to Bob Rae's time, which is 1995, when That's NDP right. was in government, the teachers went on strike in 1995 during Bob Rae's government. NDP's government. Then when the PC government, Mike Harris time, they went on strike. Then in the last 15 years, they went on strike during Dalton McGuinty's time. They went on strike during Kathleen Wynne's time. So this is not
so,
like
so, so. So it seems what you're saying is that the teachers' union is a regular to go on
every
strike.
3 years they go on strike. It's not something that the PC government or the Liberal or the NDP. We all three governments have faced the teachers' union strike, regardless of however you wanna see say it. So it is time where we make sure that we stand up for the children, and we do not want these strikes every 3 years happening. So that's why we are taking a stand right now, where we are saying, you know what, we are not going to increase the compensation to $1.5 billion, because I would rather pay that $750 million, the additional
invest in the system.
Exactly, invest in our education system. Right now, as a government, we are investing $1.3 billion in the next 3 years in our education system. So when people talk about that, the Ford government is cutting, if actually you see, we are investing more money than the previous government. There were just around 800 schools that were closed in the previous government, right? So for us, we are investing money. We have committed $13 billion in the next 10 years for capital infrastructure in schools. So we as a government are constantly investing money in our education system, in our healthcare.
And anything else you want to add on what's going on in Ontario?
Right now, I mean, the main issue is the teachers' strike. So we
yes.
are hoping that, you know, this can get resolved as soon as possible so that our kids are back in classes where they belong. We are investing in healthcare system. So, but I would really encourage your viewers to go on our government websites of different ministries and see what we are doing. And then people will know that this government is not what people talk about, that, you know, we are cutting this or that. We are rather investing money in our systems to make it better. We are trying to find efficiencies.
So you want to do everything on a tight budget, but still provide everything.
Exactly. I mean, at the end of the day, you know, we have to reduce the interest payment as well too. See, just think about it like this. If I'm able to reduce the interest payment from 13.5 to $12.5 billion, sorry, that $1 billion.
That's $1 billion saved.
Saved, but it's going to go back into the system. Right?
Yes.
It's going to go back into the system where it will go back to our healthcare system. It will go back to our education system. That's the money that we are just somewhat like interest payment is just throwing it out there right now. And that's what we are trying to control.
Well, we will catch up with you again on our next segment. Thank you for coming again to the studio.
Really appreciate it.
ਇਸ ਟਾਈਮ ਤੁਸੀਂ ਦੇਖ ਰਹੇ ਸੀਗੇ ਦ ਗ੍ਰੇਵਲ ਸ਼ੋ ਅਤੇ ਮੇਰੇ ਗੈਸਟ ਅੱਜ ਸੀਗੇ ਖਲੀਦ ਰਸ਼ੀਦੋਨੀ ਐਮ ਪੀ ਪੀ ਮਿਸਿਸਾਗਾ ਕੁਕਸਵਿਲ ਈਸਟ ਤੋਂ ਇੱਦਾਂ ਦੀ ਗੱਲਬਾਤ ਅਸੀਂ ਫਿਰ ਤੋਂ ਵੀ ਕਰਦੇ ਰਹਾਂਗੇ ਜੇਕਰ ਤੁਹਾਡੇ ਵੀ ਕੋਈ ਸਵਾਲ ਹੋਣ ਤੁਸੀਂ ਸਾਨੂੰ ਕੰਟੈਕਟ ਕਰ ਸਕਦੇ ਹੋ ਦ ਗ੍ਰੇਵਲ ਸ਼ੋ ਥੈਂਕ ਯੂ